Version 1.2 of Carl's Physics and Simulation Expander for Blender is out, and I have a lot of new features to share with you. Its main aim is to bring secondary explosions and particles to rigid bodies, but I have a lot more to offer. Let's go over how easy these new features are to use. You'll find a link to my add-on in the description. It's a paid add-on, but costs less than $1 per feature, and I'm actively improving it. The first thing I want to go over is the Voxelize function, because it was not mentioned in my first trailer. Use this button to get a version of your mesh turned into cubes or spheres. It doesn't do color yet, but it's great for getting the general shape of a model. Here's the problem. It's not filled. It's empty inside. Suzanne has no soul. So I made a fill option that will leave behind those cubes or spheres inside your mesh. It uses normals to do this, and like many other things in Blender, will work best if you apply transforms first. Here, we got a bad result, but after applying transforms, we have something much better. Be warned, this is a heavier simulation, but you can see in the two I'm showing how very different the result can be to have that extra weight in the middle. But pay attention to the counter I've included. It can take several minutes to make 12,000 of anything, especially when we need to find where they overlap. I've also improved offset animations in a number of ways. Let me give you an example. You voxelize Suzanne and set a keyframe for all the pieces. You scatter them and use an empties location to take advantage of the offset by distance function. But you can use it on the frame where Suzanne is built so that all the middle pieces come in first. Cause right, you get a different result depending on the frame where you run it. Isn't that great? Now you have a Suzanne assembling from the inside out animation, but you want to move her backward and scale up the pieces next. If you use offset animation now, you will offset all position and scale keyframes, messing with your first animation, and that sucks. The most obvious solution occurred to me. I made it so that you can say, don't touch any keyframes before X frame or even after another frame. So you can set a range. So you can say, don't touch the position and scale keyframes before 120, and it'll obey that, only offsetting this second new relocate animation. And you can, of course, use by distance here too, so the back pieces of Suzanne will move first. This is super powerful compared to other offset animation tools, yet it was so obvious when I first needed it. You see, I'm building this add-on based on my own uses, and if I need a new tool, I code it in. But what about towers? I've made improvements there too. See how it gets exponentially slower to build more and more levels with multiple towers? Well, we can now prototype a tower build by picking skip separate. This will keep the object count down. Nothing you can do about it. More objects in Blender slows things down. But we can play around with tower creation until we're happy with the result, then use the separate button to detach and center the origins of all of them at once. This is much faster. You may have noticed the new round checkbox, and it does exactly what you might hope. As of version 1.21, we now have the ability to make round towers, and I've approached this in a different way. My normal towers track an empty, but this time the empty stays in the same place. Why? So you can do things like this. Make thinner but taller towers inside each layer, and you can have a really nice looking tall tower. Hit separate connected and it's ready to simulate, or of course, just let the script separate as it goes. I recommend using skip for prototyping and setting up your simulation scene first. Something unmentioned in my first trailer is the ability to spawn objects on any mesh. You can do this with duplaverts, spawning objects on vertices or faces, but they aren't real objects. And if you do make them real, they stop following along with the animation. So we can analyze an animated mesh and make pieces to follow along with that mesh's animation. This is how I made my particle dancing girl here. After we run the script, we can also use my remove overlapping tool to search within each particle's radius and remove those that overlap. This makes things so much faster. The objects being keyframed give you a much more accurate inherent velocity, and of course, you can choose to skip keyframes and only take a pose from a particular frame, whatever one you're on. Another thing I realized is it stinks there is no facing, so I fixed it. I made it so that you can align objects with each vertex or face's normals, so things will always be pointing the right way. It expects you to point things up, just so you know. You can see how massive the difference is here on this spiky ball. To get it to align right, I just set the cone's origin point to be at the very bottom of the object, and voila! Again, remember, this is cool because these are real objects that are being cloned, so you can put particle systems or smoke and fire emitters on them and they'll actually work. It makes me sad to see those droopy particles. Let's cause some chaos. All you need to do to take advantage of this is put an emitter or something on your first object before you clone it. Don't forget a material. If you do include one, they'll be linked automatically just by nature of cloning. This video was only about new major features. See the page on Blender Market to learn a lot more about my add-on and its many functions. You can copy particle animations to rigid bodies, create secondary explosions, easily add rigid bodies and keyframe when animated or visibility starts or ends. Offset animations, or even when particle systems start. Add rigid body or collision to all selected objects with the correct weight. Make chains and constraints. There are a ton of little utilities that help you make the most of Blender and make cool simulations and animations faster. I'm extremely receptive to new ideas and have already implemented customer suggestions a few times. This add-on is a passion project for me and incorporates many ideas I wish Blender already had without resorting to complex add-ons. Thanks for watching and giving my add-on a chance. It's linked in the description if you're interested.